My name's Carol Singletary, CARO, SINGLETARY. One thing I want to say is thank y'all for coming and giving us this opportunity to share our concerns. And we also appreciate the extension of time that we've been given to do our concerns address. One thing that life has done that I want to appreciate is, concerns about staying within that 300 feet, realizing that is not a requirement when we offer our relapse. So we have offered several that would go outside that range. And so we appreciate that clarification. My husband always said it takes twice for making myself understood. That first question I had was about the actual project. When you're going to decide, is this a feasible project? Like, with all that excess of money that's already done before them, how is that considered? And also, Florida is unique. So, what due diligence are y'all considering with what have they done in the state of Florida to ensure that they have reduced their demand against the grid as much as they can? Have they used in the most energy efficient lighting in the streets, sunshine, buildings? Have they elected to try to implement, solar energy into their own federal, state, and local buildings? How much could that pull off the grid? Has the actual power that are coming into Florida, are they maximized? And that looping thing that we're talking about, is that something that could be used with the existing pipelines coming into Florida that could increase capacity to help FPNL? So those are some of the questions I have about how those things are looked at when you're making the decision on whether the actual project is necessary. But there are other alternatives that people can use to meet the demands for Florida. Has Texas been offered to help Floridians and Georgians, not in how much anybody imposed on the Florida grid, to give us access to alternative renewable resources so that can also help us come off the grid? And getting down to buildings like this where there is not in use, the lights turn off on their own. The company I work for, we can do that in every building we have, also in the heat manner. So in order to truly maximize every conservation opportunity we hold in the state, these additional resources are needed. Again, back to the relapse, that, having that understanding that we can go outside of that, also knowing that if we do have concerns or questions, I know we can very open to our phone calls and our comments when we need to get clarification, and just appreciate that due diligence to make sure that we're getting the information that we need. And I guess to that also, we have these third parties that also need information, and if I submit a reroute and it's defined, how does that process work? Do I have a way for it to be arbitrated in the event that that gym, I think, that's it. And just, I really like I-75 corridor, because there's an office, I meant that as a real, real route. And like, yeah, and if we have problems, yeah, can we get